Grace, mercy, and peace
from God our Creator and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'd like to welcome you all to this first annual Moravian Love Feast here at Brick Church. Scriptures are filled with images of light. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I be afraid? Let there be light, and there was light. And then Jesus challenging us, you are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hid. Light symbolizes the beauty and openness of this wondrous life that God has given us. And we do this in a rather unique fashion this evening. The Moravian Brotherhood, you can find at the very back of your bulletin, the last fold, or not quite the back, some history of the Moravian Love Feasts with a picture of the star. And a few important things about why we're doing this here this evening. We know that in our world today, there is much separation across religious lines, economic lines, racial lines, and more. Now, several hundred years ago, the Christian community in Europe, a section of it, was at odds with each other. They were constantly battling one another, debating about this doctrine and that doctrine. At some point, they grew tired of it. And they came together for a simple service of light. And they came up with a set of principles. And these principles were meant to do away with all sectarian differences and to focus on the love common amongst all people who look to the heavens to worship God. And it was with that understanding that we gather this evening, that whatever tradition or background you find yourself bringing you here this evening, we are grateful that you are here at Brick Presbyterian Church. And we pray that this service of light and love can bring you hope and light in wherever you might find yourself at this time. So in just a moment, I'll ask you you can turn on your illuminated candles. The switch is on the bottom in case you had trouble finding it. And feel free to hold this up anytime you are feeling inspired by the Spirit of God's presence in our midst. And now we will please join me responsively. Please stand as we join in the responsive Christ candle liturgy. O radiant light, O sun divine, of God the Father's deathless face. O Son of God, the source of life, praises your due by night and day. Our happy lips must raise the strain of your esteemed and splendid name.
Lord Jesus Christ, the daylight
fades, that shine the lights of humankind. We praise the Father with the Son, the Spirit blessed, and with the Let us pray. Gracious God, you have gathered us together this evening here in this sanctuary, but we come with different hopes and different expectations, different beliefs and understandings. But we pray by your Spirit you might unite us into one humanity filled with love for our Creator and the gift of life that he has given each person here today. May the music and the scriptures and all the words bless us in this time. In the name of the one who was, who is, and who is to come, world without end. Amen.
Thank you. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people, but the Lord will rise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn.
Matthew chapter 5, verses 14 through 16. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven.
Since ancient times, people have used light as a metaphor for understanding the very nature of God. As I said, the very first words of Scripture, and God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. For those of us who follow our Lord Jesus, he described himself as the light, but also that each one of us are the light. Now, there is something about the nature of light that has a unique and wondrous power. Now, many eons ago, millennium ago, a Greek philosopher named Plato pointed out that one day you might find yourself outdoors and perhaps seeing the beauty of a flower, and your eye is drawn towards it. And then as you gaze and drink in the beauty of that flower, you might notice one of the sunbeams coming down from the sky, hitting it just so. And that sunbeam itself is beautiful. And then finally, it might lead you to think, where did that sunbeam come from? What is the source of that which illuminates everything else? And he observed that, of course, it's the sun. But we understand that to be God's very being. So let me explain. This past week, Wendy and I, my wife Wendy and I, found ourselves in the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico. All right, true confessions, we were in Cancun and had a wonderful time. Besides resting and doing mostly nothing the whole time, we did go on one adventure. And this adventure took us into the Mexican jungle and where we explored something called a cenote. Now, some of you may know what a cenote is, but essentially it's a hole in the ground which gives you access to an underwater, underground cave. And so the guides led us down some rather treacherous steps, and we went into this cave filled with water, and in a few minutes, we were swimming around in the near darkness. Little fish would come by and say hello, and a few shafts of light were coming in just enough to give the impression of beautiful aqua water that would help us see a fish or two as we were swimming in this water. And then we saw these ancient formations of stalactites, which I remember hang tightly to the ceiling, as they always tell you, and the stalagmites growing up from the bottom, and we were mesmerized by how ancient this cave was. And then there was what looked to be tiny strands of spaghetti hanging from the ceiling of the cave. And our guide proceeded to explain to us, these are worms, and these worms glow in the dark. They are spectacular. And then we noticed, we began to think about where was the light coming in that allowed us to see anything. We looked up and there was the hole, the cenote, which let in that light in order to see this mesmerizing beauty all around us. And then, of course, we noticed the beauty of that light, aqua shimmering water that was like the light beams coming down. And of course, we realized that it was the sun that was coming in through that hole, powering all the warmth, all the light, and virtually all the life that we know it. But it wasn't only this mesmerizing natural formations that we enjoyed. Our guide Gabby and our driver Javi were so delightful. And Gabby shared with us all of the power of these ancient formations and the geological process that brought them into being. She knew all about the flora and fauna that was in this cave. But she shared something more. She shared about her Mexican culture and the ancient Mayan history and how they were builders of civilizations. And you could tell she just exuded a joy to be able to share it with us. She exuded a joy, and she was proud of her Mexican heritage and all that meant throughout history. And I think by the end, Wendy and I realized that the light illuminated these beautiful animals and plants in this cave. The light beams were shimmering and wondrous on their own. But the real gift of that experience was not the cave, and it wasn't the light, but it was getting to know Gabby and getting to know Javi and the friendship and the bonds that we shared and experienced in just a few moments that we had together. And this is the gift of God's light. God gives us the gift to enjoy this beautiful world, but most of all, God gives himself to us. And it is through one another that we see the light of God each and every day of our life. And that is why this evening we come and we worship a God beyond all praising. Amen.
Thank you.
may be seated. This evening, as you exit through the narthex doors, if you could turn your candles off and return those to the baskets, and then you are welcome to take a lantern with you. It is our gift to you if you'd like to. And then everyone is invited to a meal downstairs in Watson Hall, and we hope that you'll join us. And now receive the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord be kind and gracious unto you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you peace from this moment and forevermore. Amen.